Welcome to the next session 6. In last session we discussed remaining three properties and some examples. Today we'll discuss another examples. In last session we discussed two examples. Continue with third one. Prove that delta of x plus y, y plus z, z plus x, second z x y 1 1 1 is equal to 0. Without expanding we need to prove that value is 0. Clearly observe, in first row x y is z is not there, y z x is not there here, z x but y is not there. If we add r2 value to the r1, in every element will get x plus y plus z. That's why I am applying operation here. I am adding R1 and R2. R1 plus R2. Why? To prove 0, we have two conditions. Either two rows are identical or two rows are proportional. Now, by using that only we are doing, I am adding R1 and R2. This Z value add to the R1, what will you get? X plus Y plus Z. Here also, X plus Y plus Z. X plus y plus z. Second row, third row, no changes. 1, 1, 1. Now, as for property, we can take out common factor. Say, what is the common factor? Same value is there in every row 1 having. Each element is fixed. What? X plus y plus z. That term takes out x plus y plus z common. Remaining 1, 1, 1. Z, X, Y, 1, 1, 1. Now what happened? R1 and R3 are identical. When the two rows are identical, the value of determinant clearly what here? 0. The reason clearly what? R1, R3 identical. When two rows are, two columns are identical, value of determinant 0. We come to the next problem. Evaluate depth of 1, 1, 1. First column, second column ABC, third column BC, CA, AB. Evaluate means we need to find the simplest value, simplified value. When, simple logic, remember, when the ones are there in row wise, we need to apply column operation, because to evaluate determinant, we need to get more number of zeros along any row or column. How to get the zeros? By using operations only. Either row operations or column operations. Here, along row having ones means you need to apply column operations. If ones are there in column wise, we need to apply row operations. Like this. Now, when row wise is there ones means, we have to apply vertically to make 0. For example, C2 minus C1, C3 minus C1, this value becomes 0. That's why very simple logic you have to remember. When ones are there in column wise, we need to apply row operation to make zeros. When ones are there in row wise, we need to apply column operations to get into simplified value. Now, here ones are there in column wise. That's why to get zeros, we'll apply row operations. We need to get simplified value also. Now, our pleasure in this. For example, I want to make this is 0 by using other row. For that, we need to apply here, static as this question. For example, you want to make R1 first element by using R2. For that, we'll apply operation what here? R1 minus R2. Reason? In R1, R2, first elements are same. But I want to make this element is 0. For that, I'll subtract this two. Similarly, you want to make R2 first element also 0 by using R3. Because R1 already makes 0. Now, R2 tends to R2 minus R3. Now, we'll subtract this two. This also becomes 0. R1 minus R2. That value we need to write in R1 row only. R1 minus R2. 1 minus 1, 0. Then what is R1 element? A. R2 element? B. A minus B. Here, BC minus CA. Next, operation what here? R2 minus R3. We need to apply this operation for which row? Second row. What is the operation? R2 minus R3. Here 1 minus 1. Here 0. Next here B minus C. Here CA minus AB. Third row no changes. As it is right now. Now, let's simplify this. Let off. First column 0, 0, 1. Here A minus B. In this BC minus CA, if you take C only common, what will get? B minus A. But here what is the factor is there? A minus B. If you take minus C common, from this minus common means what will get? A minus B will get. That's why here minus C if you take common, you will get the common factor A minus B. Then coming to the second one. Already 0. Next element B minus C. What is the element is there here? CA minus AB. If you take A only common, what is the factor? C minus B. But here, B minus C is there. That's why, minus A if you take common, what will get? B minus C. So, minus A common. B minus C will get. Third row, as it is right now, C, A. Now, along row 1, there is a common factor. What? A minus B. When 0 is there, considered that is a factor is available. Because 0 into A minus B is 0 only. That's why in row 1, what is the common factor? A minus B. In row 2, B minus C. Take common. A minus B and B minus C from R2 and R3. Then the two factors common. A minus B into B minus C. What is the remaining? 0, 1 minus C. 0, 1 minus A. 1, C, A. For easy to evaluate this, now along C1 having more number of zeros. That's why this one expand along C1. Along C1 also what symbol C has sign? Plus, minus, plus. A minus B into B minus C. First two elements, plus 0, second element, minus 0. Into delta of 1 into right, because the value becomes 0 only. Last one, plus 1 into delta of, remaining 4 elements M. What is the remaining elements? By deleting its row and column, remaining 1 minus C, 1 minus A. Now here, A minus B into B minus C. A minus B into B minus F 0. 0 will get. Cancel, no problem. Now 1 into. Remaining this one expand, what will get? 1 into minus A. Minus A minus. 1 into minus C. Minus C. The minus of minus, what will get here? Plus. 1 into minus A minus A. Here AD minus BC concept we need to apply. Say 1 into minus C minus. Total minus of minus plus. Finally we can write A minus B into B minus C into minus A plus C, we can write C minus A. This is a simplified value of this given determinant. All have understood this problem? Come to the next one. The next question. Prove that delta of B plus C, A, B, C plus A, B, C, C, A plus B equal to 4 into A, B, C. We need to prove this. In each row, there is sum of two terms. Remaining repeated value, A, here B, B, here C, C. Delta of B plus C, A, B, C plus A, B, C C A plus B. Now first I will make this element a single element. Sum of two different elements is there. I will make into single element. I will make zero also. So to try to make this is zero. How to make this zero? We need subtract B. We need subtract C also. Then this value becomes zero. Now in R2 B is there. In R3 C is there. That's why I will apply this operation from R1. R1 element what is there? B plus C. From R1 I will subtract R2 and R3. Both values subtract. Then what will happen? B, R2 minus B. Cancel. C, here minus C. Now what will you get? This total value becomes 0. And comes to second element. R1 element A. When we are solving this row operation, simplification solve first. A minus R2. Minus R2 means minus C, minus A. Plus and minus, minus only. Minus R2, that is minus C. Where AA cancel. Minus C minus how much? Minus 2C. If you evaluate this, we have to solve like this. Next, here what is the element? R1 element A minus R2. Here, minus B. Minus R2 means minus A minus B. Which is cancel. AA cancel. Minus B what you will get? Minus 2B. Here B, C plus A. C, C, A plus B. Now, clearly, in row 1, what is the common term here? Minus 2 is a common factor. Take minus 2 common, what remains? 0, C, B, B, C plus A, B, C, C, A plus B. C, C, A plus B. Now, we can expand this. Now, after no need to apply any operation, no need to apply also. I am expanding along row 1 only. Along R1 expand, no problem. Now, minus 2 into total multiple. First element plus 0, no need. Second element minus C into depth of. By deleting its row and column, remaining elements what? B, B, C, A plus B. By deleting its column and row. Last element. B into depth of, by deleting first row and third column, remaining elements B, C plus A, C, C. Here, minus 2 into, here plus 0 we need to take here, minus C into, B into A plus B. What will you get? AB plus B square minus BC plus B into B into C, BC, minus C into C plus C. Overall bracket. Minus 2 into, minus C can multiply inside, minus ABC, minus B square C, minus into minus, plus BC square, because minus into minus plus B, C into C, C square. Next, B into B, B square C. B into C minus BC into C plus C. Total bracket. Now here minus 2 into. Here minus B square C plus B square C. These two values cancel. Minus ABC plus BC square. Here multiply with BC inside. Minus B into C C square. Minus into plus. Minus BC into A, ABC. Now here plus BC square minus BC square cancel. Remain what here? Minus 2 minus ABC what? Minus 2 ABC. Now minus 2 into minus 2 plus 4 into ABC. Total 4 ABC is the final value. Now directly if you expand, you won't get final value like that. For that only one operation we need to apply. How to apply means here in row 1 there is sum of two terms. Try to reduce into single value. For that I am subtracting R2 and R3 from R1. From that this value becomes 0. Remaining you will get minus 2C minus 2B. Take minus 2 common. Then expand along row 1 you will get the final value 4ABC.